World War I was a devastating war filled with death and loss. In fact, over 37 million people died as a result of it. Despite this, major medical advancements were made. Although often overshadowed by the technological and military advancements made, medicine also drastically improved and served a vital role in the war. Similarly, many war heroes were remembered after the war, but nurses and doctors were overlooked. One of these being Dr. Isabella Stenhouse. Just before the war broke out, she earned qualifications to be a doctor. In 1915, she began working at a French Red Cross hospital. While there, Isabella learned how to utilize anesthetics, treat wounds, and treat bacterial infections. By the end of 1916, Dr. Stenhouse was recruited as a medic to treat soldiers. However, this is only half the process to saving them.
The improvements in how wounded soldiers were transported to safety was essential to the war. During its earlier stages, injured or deceased soldiers were carried by horse and cart to the CCS, or Casualty Clearing Station. Horse-drawn carts were extremely slow and limited, as the cart could not hold too many people. Another way of transporting injured men was being taken to the CCS by stretcher, carried by stretcher bearers. This was also extremely ineffective, since it required 4 to 8 stretcher bearers to carry one injured man. The invention of ambulances greatly increased the survival rate of injured men, as it was quicker and more suitable for battlefield conditions and terrains. Even if retrieved from battle, there was no guarantee the soldiers would be treated. The casualty clearing stations were constantly overcrowded, due to a total of 15,000 to 20,000 soldiers injured on a daily basis from all fronts of war. Dr. Stenhouse was requested by France to work at one of these CCSs near the front lines. However, it was harder for a doctor to operate at a CCS. They were unhygienic, understaffed, overcrowded, lacked sophisticated equipment, and constantly lacked supplies. If a soldier required more time or better technology to recover, they were sent to base hospitals located far away from the front lines in the homeland.
Another problem that Dr. Stenhouse faced was a vast number of possible wounds and diseases. New technology introduced in the war inflicted injuries that had never been seen before. However, when Dr. Stenhouse was stationed to the island of Malta, she primarily treated various diseases. These diseases also spread like wildfire during the war due to the lack of sanitation and hygiene, both in trenches and hospitals. Spanish influenza was one of these deadly diseases that killed hundreds of thousands. These unsanitary conditions in the trenches also caused trench foot, which was the rotting of skin, as well as trench fever. In fact, diseases like these and many more killed more men than machine guns did. After serving in Malta for a year, Stenhouse was moved to Egypt, where she served as a surgeon. Due to the nature of the war, a multitude of physical injuries were prevalent, from leg injuries to abdominal injuries. Besides treating artillery and bullet-inflicted injuries, Dr. Stenhouse describes that gas-related injuries and adverse psychological conditions were also common during the war. Examples include mustard gas and shell shock.
The immense pressure that doctors such as Stenhouse experienced to treat the wounded led to the field of medicine flourishing. As a surgeon, Stenhouse had to perform amputations, which was a process crucial for nearly all physical injuries. During World War I, specialized amputations for different parts of the body were developed, which increased the soldier's chance for survival. Soldiers that lost part of their face could also have plastic surgeries performed on them. Dr. Stenhouse also used new ways to prevent and reduce infection while doing her work. One of these techniques was to remove tissue around an open wound, then use carbolic lotion to both wash the wound and soak gauze in it before the gauze was wrapped around the wound. There was also a great deal of development in anesthetics. Shock gas and cocaine hydrochloride were some of the most effective anesthetics to soothe soldiers under extreme pain, especially after surgery. Innovations to help broken bones recover were also developed. The Thomas splint, a splint for the leg, reduced the mortality rate from leg-related fractures from 80% to 20%.
Even though Dr. Stenhouse discontinued her medical work in 1918, the contributions of doctors like her was enormous. Today, the concept of antiseptics are used to treat wounds. The speed in which the wounded are brought to safety is vital, and the cleanliness of hospitals is a given. The death and destruction of World War I is undeniable, but perhaps someday in the future, the medical advancements that resulted from it will save more lives than the fighting took. Thank you.